The custodial deaths of Jayaraj and Benix at the Sathankulam police station in the Thirukkural district of Tamil Nadu have resulted in anger and uproar due to the sheer scale of torture and violence perpetrated by the police. This incident has ignited the debate on the use of third degree methods by police to extract confessions and statements. The anger has erupted at a time when the global anger following the death of George Floyd is far from dying down. As per India Annual Report on Torture 2019 published by the National Campaign Against Torture, a total of 1,731 people died in custody in India during 2019. The report says 1,606 deaths happened in judicial custody and 125 in police custody. Out of these 125 deaths in police custody, Uttar Pradesh topped the list with 14 deaths, followed by Tamil Nadu and Punjab with 11 deaths each, and Bihar witnessed 10 deaths. The same report also said that as per analysis, 5 custodial deaths happened in India on daily basis. Out of these 125 cases in the police custody, 93 persons, which is 74.4%, died due to alleged torture or foul play, while 24, which is 19.2%, died under suspicious circumstances. NCAT's analysis also revealed that 75, which is 60% of these 125, belonged to the poor and the marginalized communities and sections. They included 13 from backward and tribal communities, and 15 were Muslims, while 35 were picked up for petty crimes. 3 of them were farmers, 2 were security guards, 2 drivers, a laborer, a rag picker, and a refugee. As per the same report, women continued to be tortured or targeted for sexual violence in custody, and the victims often belonged to the weaker sections. The NCAT also said that the death of at least 4 women in police custody were reported in 2019. In an article published in the Hindustan Times, Raja Bagga, a senior researcher in the police reform program of the Commonwealth Human Rights Initiative, said that in 2018, the National Crime Record Bureau's latest annual report recorded 70 deaths in police custody. 14 of these were from Gujarat and 12 were from Tamil Nadu. And out of these 70 cases, judicial inquiries were ordered only in 28 matters, and charge sheets were filed against 13 police personnel. He also says, in Tamil Nadu, no police personnel were arrested, let alone charge sheeted. The Prevention for Torture Bill 2010 was a step in that direction to make it a law. This bill was introduced in the Lok Sabha on 26th April 2010 by the then Home Minister P. Chidambaram and was passed on 6th May 2010 in the Lok Sabha. Then it was sent to the Rajya Sabha Select Committee, but it was not passed in the Rajya Sabha and has so far not seen the light of the day. The Prevention of Torture Bill 2010 defined the torture and punishment for torture committed by public servants. The Section 3 of the bill defined torture broadly as whoever, being a public servant, tries to obtain and extract information or confession which intentionally ensures grievous injury or hurt, whether mentally or physically, is said to inflict torture. The lapsed bill provided for 10 years imprisonment for the act of torture as a definition. It said that when torture is committed for gaining a confession or other information for detecting an offense, and if it is committed on grounds such as religion, race, language, caste, or any other ground, it shall imply punishment for torture. The Select Committee of the Rajya Sabha said that definition of torture should be inconsistent with the UN Convention. The Select Committee further said that women and children should be given special consideration and attempt to torture should be made an offense. The same committee said that public servant definition should include all government institutions under its purview. Former Law Minister Ashwani Kumar filed a writ petition before the Supreme Court of India for ensuring an effective and purposeful legislative framework, laws, and enforcement to fulfill the constitutional promise of human dignity and prevention of custodial torture. The petitioner said that the Prevention of Torture Bill 2010 was already passed in the Lok Sabha and that the Torture Convention needs to be ratified through legislative process. On 27th November 2017, the Supreme Court disposed of the writ petition on the basis of the statement of Attorney General Sri K.K. Venugopal that the prayer made in the writ petition has been subject matter of discussion in the Law Commission, which has already made certain recommendations. KK also said that the report is being seriously considered by the government. The Law Commission, headed by Justice B.S. Chauhan, in its 273rd report recommended the government to ratify and implement the Convention Against Torture. The Commission also recommended a new bill, the Prevention of Torture Bill 2017, to be considered by the government in India. The Law Commission recommended and suggested that causing mental, physical or psychological injury which is done either intentionally or involuntarily amounts to torture. The Commission concluded that several existing CRPCs, Indian Evidence Act 1872 and IPC, needs amendments and recommended stringent punishment also to perpetrators of such acts. The Commission's first recommendation was consideration by the central government to ratify Convention Against Torture. The Commission's second recommendation was amendments needed in Criminal Procedure Code 1973 and the Indian Evidence Act 1872. Under Criminal Procedure Code 1973, Section 357B needs to change and Section 326A or Section 376D of the IPC 1860 needs to change. The Commission also recommended insertion of Section 114B in Indian Evidence Act 1872, which means that if a person sustains any injury under custody, it will be presumed that the police inflicted those injuries and need to give an explanation for that. The Commission's third recommendation was stringent punishment of up to life imprisonment and fine to the perpetrators of torture. However, these recommendations were not implemented by the central government by producing the amendments and the law in the parliament. Dr. Ashwani Kumar, the petitioner in the writ petition, filed an application in 2018 before the Supreme Court with a prayer to implement the Law Commission's recommendation. But the Supreme Court dismissed this on 5th September 2019 in a bench comprising of then Chief Justice of India Ranjan Gogoi, Justice Dinesh Maheshwari and Justice Sanjeev Khanna. The Supreme Court rejected the prayer for issuance of a direction to the center to enact a standalone law against custodial torture by holding that the court cannot direct the parliament to enact laws. So what is the present status of anti-torture bill in this country? India's anti-torture bill has been in coma for almost 10 years now. The question regarding the implementation of the Law Commission's recommendations was discussed in the Supreme Court. But then Attorney General of India informed the Supreme Court on 22nd January 2019 that the central government has transferred the draft of Prevention of Torture Bill 2017 to all the states for the inputs and comments. The Attorney General also said that only 8 states and union territories have responded to this so far. So even now, the Prevention of Torture Bill 2017 has not been introduced in the House of the Parliament.